Now, the good news is this truly is the end of days, end of times, and we're all getting to witness, I mean, grab your popcorn, a dying empire collapse. It was fun while it lasted, and it only lasted a few hundred years. And now, well, it's the end. I'm Christopher Green. I love you guys. This is the hardcore truth. Again, I'm not selling anything, just telling you what's going on. Like and share this video. Love you guys so much, and Jesus Christ is King.
Hey, Shalom to my Akim, Wa Akwathim, and Yahweh Shai Hamashiach. Greetings to all my brothers and sisters in the Lord. And this had came up on my news feed on Google. You know, the Spirit quickened me to go ahead and do a little edification on the topic, man. And this is about the Vatican trying to implement a global ceasefire effectively and promptly, right? There's talks of peace, you know, and this prompted me to get right into it, man. The majority of people really believe that at the end of all this pestilence, economic calamity, you know, natural calamities, all these things that are going on, people really believe that there's going to be a light at the end of the tunnel, and that this current state and current kingdom of the world, being the West, under the Vatican, ironically, and these Zionist Jays, we're going to call them Jays, trying to get flagged. You know, they believe that, you know, things can go back to normal and there's going to be peace and, you know, everything's going to be fine again. And I'm here to, unfortunately, burst their bubble, man, and hit y'all with the truth. And I pray that this lesson be edifying for the elect and even the unlearned, man, that they may even be sealed with this truth, man. You know, but I got a nice little lesson lined up. We're going to just talk about this real quick. You know, I'm going to try to run through it. Hopefully this won't be too lengthy at all, man. But, just a couple of days ago, says, man, the Pope implement global ceasefire effectively and promptly. Pope Francis says he hopes the new UN Security Council resolution calling for a global ceasefire will be implemented effectively and promptly in order to provide aid for people suffering the effects of the COVID-19 pandemic. Okay. It's a lot. This is by Vatican News. Just going to read over. Pope Francis has once again lent his support to appeals for a global ceasefire in the wake of the coronavirus pandemic. The call for a global and immediate ceasefire is commendable, which would allow the peace and security essential to provide the humanitarian assistance so urgently needed, he said in remarks following the Angelus on Sunday. Okay? Says a magistrum for peace and against hypocrisy. Wow. The Pope wants to talk about hypocrisy, man. The whole Catholic ordinance is based on hypocrisy, based on Judaic practices mixed with paganism. And that goes from the Emperor Constantine. You know what I mean? So the whole religion in general, this is the harlot. This is the harlot in the Book of Revelations, man. Because all these religions came from the Catholic institution, man. Believe it or not, came from the Vatican, man. You know, even Islam. That's a whole nother thing, you know. Farrakhan did all that chopping, but he ain't want to bring that up, you know. Malcolm X found that out. That might be one of the reasons why he's not here no more. But that's another video for another time, man. But on the 1st of July, members of the United Nations Security Council unanimously adopted a resolution demanding a general and immediate cessation of hostilities in all situations on its agenda. The resolution calls on parties to armed conflicts to immediately, in a durable humanitarian phase, provide aid to countries to help fight the COVID-19 pandemic. In the resolution, the Council also voiced support for UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres, who first proposed a global ceasefire on the 23rd of March. That appeal has been echoed by world leaders, including Pope Francis, who at the Angelus on the 29th of March invited everyone to follow it up by ceasing all forms of hostilities, encouraging the creation of corridors for humanitarian aid, openness to diplomacy, and attention to those who find themselves in situations of vulnerability, man. So, you know, they're talking about peace, you know, us elect, we know that ain't what the deal is. That's not on the menu. Peace is not on the menu, man, you know, and we're going to just cut this out. I don't even want to read the rest. Let me go ahead and just read it for, you know. Just to be thorough. In response to the Security Council's resolution, Pope Francis this Sunday said the call for a global and immediate ceasefire, which would allow the peace and security essential for providing the humanitarian assistance so urgently needed, is commendable. He said he hoped that this decision will be implemented effectively and promptly for the sake of many people who are suffering throughout the world. Oh, the suffering is just beginning, baby. You people don't even know what suffering is yet. Yahweh Bashim, Yahweh Shah is just rubbing his hands together, man, on this earth, man. Pope Francis prayed that the Security Council resolution might become a courageous first step towards a peaceful future. Well, we're going to cut right into this, man. This is going to be called, ain't going to be no peace, man. Ain't no damn peace, man. That's not on the menu, baby. And we're going to cut right into it, man. Because Yahweh Shah HaMashiach told us this even from the beginning when he walked on the earth, man. Matthew chapter 10, verse 34, man. Think not that I come to send peace on earth. I came not to send peace, but a sword. And what's happening right now in this world, and what's going to continue to happen, is that Yahweh Shah is going to bathe his sword, okay, his sword of justice and judgment and rebuke, okay, on the earth. You understand? He's about to bathe his sword, and he's already doing it. COVID-19 ain't nothing compared to what's coming. There's more plagues, more pestilence, you know. We see this economy about to crash. It's about to go down, man. The race war is tensioning up. You know, everything is opposite of peace. It ain't going to be no peace. But, you know, the average person will come across that article on Google, and they would go hand in hand with that vibration, man. They would come to agreement with it, believing that there's going to be peace and to promote peace. And you know what? It's all staged, because that's what this New World Order is going to promote. World humanitarianism and peace. Meanwhile, all reality is going to say the contrary. We're coming into tribulation. That's what's on the menu. Destruction. Okay? Justice. Judgment. You know? And it is just that Yahweh Bashim, Yahweh Shai brings this judgment. Okay? We're going to go through why through this video, man. Okay? But let's go to 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 3 through 6. For when they shall sell Salakia, for when they shall say peace and safety, then sudden destruction cometh upon them as travail upon a woman with child, and they shall not escape. But ye, brethren, are not in the darkness, that day should overtake you as a thief. See, those who are in meditation with these scriptures, man, who Yahweh Bashim, Yahweh Shai is dealing with, man, and has opened the eyes and opened the ears of, we're not blinded. We're not in the darkness. We see exactly what time it is, you know. So it's not going to overtake us as a thief. We know what's coming because we understand the prophecies. But majority of these people out here, man, they don't know what's coming. They have no idea. So they can be deceived. They can be lied to, you know, by Pope Francis, you know, and by this rhetoric of peace and security and safety. That's not what's coming, man, at all. We're going to get into what's coming. Deeply, we're going to get into what's coming for the world and for the West. For the daughter of Babylon and for the world at large. It says, ye are the children of light and the children of day. We are not of the night nor of the darkness. Therefore, let us not sleep as others do, but let us watch and be sober. So we're watching. We know what's going down. We see what's happening. You know, everything we see, we're filtering through the scriptures on our everyday life. That's what kind of developed this lesson right here. Because, you know, we filter everything through the word of Yahweh Bashim, Yahweh Shah, because it is living and everything written shall come to pass, man. And let every man be a liar. So the Pope is a liar. These people are liars, man. The UN Council, they're all liars, man. They know there ain't no damn peace on the menu. They're going to feed you that pile of crap, though. And y'all going to believe it, man. Most of these people are going to believe it. But the elect shall not be deceived, man. Let's go to Ezekiel chapter 7, verse 25. Okay, destruction cometh. They shall seek peace, and there shall be none. It's going to be zero peace. It's going to get worse and worse and worse, man. Okay? Let's go to Isaiah 48:22. There is no peace, saith the Lord, unto the wicked. Man, there ain't no peace for the wicked. And the world is spearheaded through the philosophies of the West, man. And really, even all these heathens and Gentiles are wicked, deep in their idolatries and, you know, they're lawless. Although the law was appointed to Jacob, but nonetheless, you know, all of them are out of pocket, man. But they're spearheaded and they're starting to take on the philosophies of Esau, Edom, okay, of the daughter of Babylon. So this whole world is turned upside down right now. Righteous peace will not be here until righteousness is here. And that's not going to be here until Yahawashi Hamashiach comes back and sets up the 12 tribes of Israel back in their homeland. And the world is forced, okay, is forced to follow the law, statutes, and commandments. That's when it's going to be peaceful out here. But pertaining to the wicked, for the lawless, for the wicked, adulterous generation, this generation, this modern day and time, ain't no peace on the menu, baby. That's how, that's 86, man. We got to 86 that, cancel that, cross that out. That ain't happening, you know? Let's go to Job chapter 9, verse 24. This is why there ain't no peace, because there ain't no peace for the wicked. And Job 9, 24 tells us the earth is given into the hand of the wicked. He covered the faces of the judges thereof. If not, where and who is he? Is these Edomites, man? It's Esau, Edom, man. Covering the faces of the judges thereof, man. Yeah, that's exactly what they did during the Renaissance, man. Painting over, doing the whitewashing, painting over the prophets, painting over the angels, whitening the skin of the Messiah, putting their image up, putting the image of an Edomite up there to be worshipped and adored. You got a lot of these jakes who have these idols hanging in their houses, man. These false imageries, you know. Cover the faces of the judges, man. I'm telling you where and who he is, man. The wicked that the Bible speaks of. It's Esau, Edom, man. Point blank, period. I mean, there's no need to really get too much further in that. If you don't get it, you're going to get it. Because the truth shall be declared, man. Then you're going to see it with your own eyes. Right? Let's continue. Obadiah chapter 1, verse 6 through 8. Okay? How are the things of Esau searched out? How are his hidden things sought up? I don't know if y'all keep the vibration, man, and staying conscious of everything that's been going on over the last 5 years, but a lot of Esau's BS has been uncovered and been exposed from them putting their kids through college and basically paying off these colleges to where their children are getting in, although they're dumbasses and can't pass their SATs. They're basically cheating, man. They get their kids in these schools. You know what I mean? I remember that was a big thing, you know. Paying off to get higher scores on the test for their children to get admission into these high level schools and stuff like that. Obvious racism and prejudice. I mean, that's been obvious because we're in captivity. A lot of you jakes don't understand that this is not a place to really set your abode, man, and to set your future in right now, because we're at the end and this is the end of a captivity. You understand? We came captives and we never was equal. There really was never no equality. And that's how it's supposed to be, man, because this is a captivity. You understand? Let's continue. All the men of thy confederacy have brought thee even to the border, okay? So that's what's about to happen. That peace, these other nations right now, as I'm making this video, are devising an attack against the daughter of Babylon. We're going to talk about this. The men that were at peace with thee have deceived thee and prevailed against thee. They that eat thy bread have laid a wound under thee. There is no understanding in him. Shall I not in that day, saith the Lord, even destroy the wise men out of Edom and the understanding out of the mount of Esau? So all these countries are secretly getting ready to combat this place, man, this whore. Okay? We're talking about America. Okay? The UN is all torn apart. You know, where the allies, like Turkey, for example. You know, certain allies we had are now playing at 50. You know what I'm saying? Everybody going to play at 50 on Babylon and let this place have it, man. That's what's going on. That peace. That's not what's happening. And we know that he conditions the hearts of the kings and turn it whichever way that he will. You know, so really the Most High is behind this, man. You know, these other countries see how the economy's doing. They see the dissidents on the streets of America. They see that everything's chaotic over here so far. So they're taking their time to this would be the perfect time to strike this place, man. And that's what's about to happen. It's about to be a Red Dawn event, and we're going to talk about that. Okay, we're going to talk about that because blood has to be recompensed here, man. Blood has to be recompensed here in America in the West, the daughter of Babylon, because by blood this place was established. It just is what it is. This place is cursed, man. You know, let's go to Isaiah 33:1. Woe to thee that spoilest, and thou wast not spoiled, and dealest treacherously, and they dealt not treacherously with thee. When thou shalt cease to spoil, thou shalt be spoiled, and when thou shalt make an end to deal treacherously, they shall deal treacherously with thee. And that's what's about to happen, man. America's been the hammer to earth, been bullying the whole entire world, man, forcing everybody into this monopoly Federal Reserve money. You know, in every country that wants to deal in the gold standard, we wind up going to war with them. You know, we have the government, the CIA, forming dissidents in other countries, setting up political leaders to turn their countries out and extort their riches. You know, like in Africa, like even with Gaddafi, you know, in Libya, the formation of ISIS. You know, they caused this chaos in other countries to extort them, man, and to gain power over their lands. You know, setting up puppet politicians, all that, man. The treachery runs very deep to those who are learned, have eyes to see it, man. You know, but most of our people don't see this because they don't look into it. They take the narrative of the media, which is owned by the same people who are behind the wars, okay, and behind all this wickedness that's going on, okay. America, the daughter of Babylon, that whore of earth, man, is the one place that has military bases all over the world and other places, man. They keep us not at home, and we're about to get into it. Let's go to Habakkuk chapter 2, verse 3 through 8. For the vision is yet for an appointed time, but at the end it shall speak and not lie. Though it tarry, wait for it, because it shall surely come. It will not tarry. Salakia, that indigestion. Behold, his soul, which is lifted up, is not upright in him, but the just shall live by his faith. Yea, also, because he transgresses by wine, which is the philosophy, man. America is in Esau, Edom in general, is a transgressor by his philosophy, man. They are lawless people, okay? He is a proud man. Yeah, make America great again. Neither keep us at home. Like I said, America's one of the only places that got embassies and military bases established in all these other countries, okay? Who enlarges his desire as hell and is as death, and cannot be satisfied, but gathers unto him all nations and heapeth unto him all people. And that's what they're doing right now. You know, they've been doing it militarily, and they're going to continue to do it militarily by trying to take control of certain regions with resources, oil, gold, things of this nature, you know, trying to debo and force all the other nations to deal with their fake monopoly Federal Reserve notes. And now they're going to do it in the form of the new wave, which is going to be an RFID chip in the new world order and a new currency, man, which is going to be that RFID chip. And they're going to try to chip and take over the whole world. So Esau's trying to force his blessing, man. We all know how that's going to go, you know. Yahweh Shai HaMashiach is going to gather all these nations in the Valley of Jehoshaphat and put them all to death, man. And bring his righteous rulership here and gather his children from the four corners of the earth, from the 12 tribes of Israel. Okay? And then there's going to be peace after the slaughter. You understand? Well, let's continue. So now all these take up a parable against him and a taunting proverb against him and say, woe to him that increases that which is not his. How long? And to him that ladeth himself with thick clay, being debts. And look at the American debt right now, man. This place is in debt. The Federal Reserve note is monopoly money right now, man. The U.S. Mint has ceased and is ceasing making coins. And it's just starting with coins. It's going to go to dollar bills. This dollar's done, man. It's done. And most of the people don't understand it. Like, I was just watching a video. Not just one video, but all the time, man. We see online, especially Jake, like throwing money in the club, you know, making it rain. Man, yeah, I remember a couple years ago in Venezuela when it was like 2 years ago when they was having an economic collapse and a famine, and the men of the Lord even then was saying, this is coming to America. We're on a turning point where this is about to literally happen in America, man. Where, you know, in Venezuela, when their money was all blowing in the wind in the streets, all on the streets. I did a video on that. It was like a year or two ago, maybe a year and a half ago. You know, that's coming to America, man. And Venezuela was caught slipping because they were backing their currency based off the Federal Reserve. So all these other nations are getting angry at this whore, man. They're pissed off at America. Because once America's economy collapses, it's going to affect all these nations. Because all these nations laid in bed with this place, man. And that's one of the reasons why they're going to rise up against this, against America, against this horde, man. Let's continue. Shall they not rise up suddenly that shall bite thee, and awake that shall vex thee, and thou shalt be for booties unto them? So America's about to get spoiled. Ain't no peace. It's about to be war out this bitch, man. Because thou hast spoiled many nations, all the remnant of the people shall spoil thee, because of men's blood, and for the violence of the land, of the city, and of all that dwell therein. Chiefly and primarily the violence against Jacob. You know, against you Jakes, man. You so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Negroes, man. Esau been doing you dirty over here. For even from the border crisis, man, where he was separating the northern tribe, the northern tribe Israelites, which is them Latin tribes, you know, from their families and putting the children in these FEMA camps. Holding centers, you know, separating the families. We know how Esau get down. We know he was running through them kids and abusing them children, man. I mean, come on now. There's no need to even really get into all that. But, you know, that's what Esau has done, man. Perpetually has been violent, chiefly against Jacob, man. Both the southern tribes and the northern tribes, man. But the scriptures say we will serve our captivity together. So it's just a fruition of the curses. The curses are wrapping up on Jacob, man. And now the curses is about to hit the world. You know, right now we're talking about Esau, Edom in the West. Okay, because they're spearheaded in the power of the world right now. But this is going to encapsulate the entire earth and all the nations. And we're going to get into that in a minute. Now let's go to Habakkuk chapter 2, verse 12. Woe to him that buildeth a town with blood, establish a city by iniquity. How is America built, man? It's just the truth, man. Through the slaughtering of the natives, the 10 northern tribes that were already here between the North and South Americas, you know, and the slaughtering being done by these damn Edomites, the various tabernacles of Esau, okay? From the French to the British to the Portuguese to the Spaniards, okay? The Spaniards and the Portuguese was off in South America killing off the indigenous Israelites who were there and forcing them to Catholicism and torturing them, all these different methods of torture, man. It gets really effed up, man, what the papacy did, what the Roman papacy did. You understand? Oh, excuse me. Those who follow the doctrine of the Roman Catholic papacy. You understand? Which were these Spaniards and the Portuguese. Spain is in Europe. Portugal is in Europe. You feel me? This is the main head. And then Esau took over that land. That's not even his freaking land, man. Everywhere he goes, just he buildeth a town with blood and establish a city by iniquity, man. Okay? Through his unjust laws, after he establishes his town, you know? When I say unjust laws, I'm talking about the laws of Yahweh, Hashem, Yahweh Shai. Everything he does is contrary to those laws, man. And the laws is the lamp unto our feet. The laws is the righteous way. Esau normalizes the anti-Hamashiach, the anti-Christ doctrine, and his philosophies and his ways of life. You know, they can marry animals. I mean, that's what they do, man. Even Job said he wouldn't even leave his animals around these Edomites, man. They're going to bend over and let Scooby, these Edomite women bend over and let Scooby-Doo have his way with them, man, when her husband's at work. And these Edomite men be putting their rods in animals too, man. Like, real talk, that's just for example. Pedophilia, especially the vine of Sodom and Gomorrah, man, LGBT, and it's just a mess here, man. But their dead bodies shall lay in the streets of that city that is spiritually called Sodom and Egypt, man. And that's America, man. That's what's coming. That peace. You understand? Let's go to Ezekiel 35, 3-9. And say unto it, thus saith the Lord God, Yahweh Bashim, Yahweh Shai, behold, O Mount Seir, talking about you Edomites, I am against thee, and I will stretch out my hand against thee, and I will make thee most desolate. I will lay thy cities waste, and thou shalt be desolate, and thou shalt know that I am the Lord. Because thou hast had a perpetual hatred, and hast shed the blood of the children of Israel by the force of the sword in the time of their calamity, in the time that their iniquity had an end. Okay? Because right now, we still getting slaughtered out here, man. They still finding bodies hanging in Georgia. You know, these other southern states, man. They still... I mean, we've been exposing this, man. You know, the Jake's been oppressed. You know what I'm saying? And it is what it is. Whether you like it or not. And I'm not a sympathizer for our people either, because two-thirds of our people are going to die. Most of these so-called niggas going to die, man. A lot of these Israelites about to get put to death. But it's because they refuse the doctrine and they refuse the truth of Yahweh Bashim, Yahweh Shai. They don't want the truth, man. And they're honestly Babylonianized. Their minds are alienated from the ways of the Lord. You know, so I'm not sympathizing for our people. A lot of our people deserve, you know, the various forms of oppression that they're going through. Because the real reason why people are being oppressed in the first place is because they have been harlots and turning their back and on the Most High, man. So what? The Most High used the wicked to oppress them. Even King David said in the Book of Psalms, "Deliver my soul from the wicked, who is thy sword." You understand? See, our people are too stupid to realize that. Want to go out here and protest and march, "Black Lives Matter, Black Lives Matter," but you lawless. Yahweh Shai is not gonna be with you for your cause, man. Cause you wanna push forth LGBT. You're still sucking on the vine of Esau, Edom, and of Sodom and Gomorrah. So most of the people protesting about to be put to death. Those are your two-thirds, man. Now you have Grandmaster Jay and the Not Fucking Around Coalition. You know what I'm saying? That's prophecy. That's Micah the fifth chapter. You know, that's prophecy. Jacob gonna ride. Even two-thirds gonna ride. But where's your beard, man? You know? Why is your face naked? You know, our people wanna fight and they feel oppressed and they wanna rise up against it, but they have abandoned their power. And their power is Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai. And in the keeping of the laws to your best ability. See, our forefathers of ancient knew this. It's because we went off from this truth, man. We went off from our power that we getting destroyed. You understand? But Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai is also gonna discipline his sword. And curses are upon our enemies as well. You know, and that's what we're reading about. And who's our enemies? All the nations. Chiefly and primarily Esau, Edom, no. Right? So it says, "Therefore, as I live, saith the Lord God, I will prepare thee unto blood, and blood shall pursue thee. Since thou have not hated blood, even blood shall pursue thee." So blood is about to pursue these people out here, man. Meaning it's about to be a lot of death and destruction. "Thus will I make Mount Seir most desolate, and cut off from it him that passeth out and him that returneth. And I will fill his mountains with his slain men, in thy hills and in thy valleys and in all thy rivers shall they fall that are slain with the sword. I'll make thee perpetual desolations, and thy city shall not return. Ye shall know that I am the Lord." Yeah, that's what's on the menu. And we're talking about America. We're talking about the West. Especially Babylon America is about to get invaded, man. That you seen that movie Red Dawn? Yeah, these Russians about to be over here. These Iranians about to be over here. Your enemy is already in the gates. They're already here. So it's going to be attacks, real terrorist attacks out here, man. You know, I made videos about it and what I've seen, what the Lord showed me, man. I seen Ishmaelites, Arabs, hanging out of car windows and just dogging everybody they saw, just shooting at everybody. Missile strikes. I seen them. Nukes going off. I seen it. This is the chaos that's coming. Ain't no peace. Ain't no peace on the menu, man. Nothing but desolation and destruction. But Baba Ball, man, destroy the death to America, man. It is what it is. These are judgments from the hands of the Lord, whether people like it or not. We know that Esau thinks that he's going to continue forever, and that they're just going to come out, you know, Phoenix out of the fire, rising out of the ashes. You know that nah, this shit is the end. this is the last kingdom before Yahweh Shai returns, man, and sets Israel up in the kingdom on earth forever and ever. You know what I'm saying? So it's a beautiful thing. Let's go to Isaiah chapter 24, verse 1 through 6. "Behold, the Lord maketh the earth empty and maketh it waste and turneth it upside down and scattereth abroad the inhabitants thereof." Does that sound like peace to you? Good, because it ain't. "And it shall be as with the people, so with the priest, as with the servant, so with his master, as with the maid, so with her mistress, as with the buyer, so with the seller, as with the lender, so with the borrower, as with the taker of usury, so with the giver of usury to him." Yeah, everybody gonna get it. Everybody gonna get it, man. "The land shall be utterly empty and utterly spoiled, for the Lord has spoken this word. The earth mourneth and fadeth away. The world languisheth and fadeth away. The haughty people of the earth do languish. The earth also is defiled under the inhabitants thereof, because they have what? Transgressed the laws, changed the ordinances, and broken the everlasting covenant," okay, which was given to the nation of Israel through the hands of the prophet Moses. You understand? Babylon America is the chief place on this earth that goes against everything that is righteous, and then influences the world to follow her whorish ways. Okay? Therefore hath the curse devoured the earth, and they that dwell therein are desolate. Therefore the inhabitants of the earth are burned, and few men left. Now they're going to get burned from these thermonuclear warfare, man. Now some Akim teach that in America will be utterly destroyed. You know what I'm saying? Eventually. But some Akim teach that you know, these missiles are going to come, and that's kind of just going to be the end. Nah, I mean, I've been saying this, but that's not really going to... I mean, they're going to come. The end is going to follow, too, eventually. But Yahweh Shah said the fire would already be kindled upon his return, man. This, Isaiah 24, 1 through 6, is talking about before Yahweh Shah comes back. Men are about to be made few upon the earth. These wars are going to pop off, man. These nukes are going to go off, and people is going to kill millions of people, man. And there's not going to be a lot of people on the earth left. It's going to be like the Book of Eli. We're going to experience a Book of Eli type of situation with Denzel Washington. Okay, if y'all seen that movie, we're going to experience that before Yahweh Shah come back. Yeah, the cities are going to be destroyed. And that's when majority of Israel is going to be unblinded. But two-thirds is going to be caught up in this destruction and be destroyed, man. So if you ain't got Yahweh Shah, if he's not hearing your prayers, man... Man, you're going to be down bad, yo. It's going to be really bad out here. No peace, no security. It's going to be cities that are burnt up and buildings that are leveled. It's going to be apocalyptic out here. That's what's coming. Yeah, that's what's coming to the earth, chiefly and primarily to Esau, Edom. But that's what's coming to the earth, man. Go to Jeremiah, the 25th chapter, verse 15 through 31. For thus saith the Lord God of Israel unto me, take the wine cup of this fury at my hand, and cause all the nations to whom I send thee to drink it. And they shall drink it and be moved and be mad because of the sword that I will send among them. Hold up. Then we open this up with in the book of Matthew. Let's go to it. 10:34. Think not that I come to send peace upon the earth. I came not to send peace but a sword. There you go. Jeremiah 25. That's all. It's going for all the nations, man. 25 verse Jeremiah 25. Let's go back to let's just read it over. For thus saith the Lord God of Israel unto me, take the wine cup of this fury at my hand, and cause all the nations to drink, to whom I send thee to drink it. And they shall drink and be moved and be mad because of the sword that I will send among them. Then I took the cup at the Lord's hand and made all the nations to drink unto whom the Lord has sent me, to wit, Jerusalem and the cities of Judah and the kings thereof and the princes thereof, to make them a desolation and astonishment and hissing and a curse, as it is this day. And that's prophetic, right? Because that goes hand in hand with Ezekiel 9 and Peter 4:17, that the judgment of Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shah, starts with his own tabernacle. He starts with Israel. You understand? So that actually happened, man. You know, the northern 10 tribes got annihilated, destroyed, and thinned out by Esau, Edom, okay? Here in North and South Americas, you know, the 10 northern tribesmen. And then the southern 3 tribes were overthrown by the Romans, migrated into West Africa, and then sold by the Hamites into chattel slavery in the hands of Esau again. And the scriptures tell us that the northern, that Ephraim and Judah, that's the northern and the southern tribes, will be in captivity together. And that's what's happening. Okay? And we're a proverb and a hissing and a curse unto this day. You understand? So Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai made our people drink that cup first. Okay? This is why you don't get no peace, Israel. This is why there ain't no love for you over here. Cause you in captivity, boy. Because you're supposed to be looking toward new heaven and a new earth where righteousness dwells. Okay? That's what you should be looking for. You should be looking to inherit the land that Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shah promised unto your forefathers. That's what our people should be looking for. But no, our people are looking to enhance their life on a sinking ship. You feel me? Which is Babylon America, man. And when Jacob's trouble pop, that's going to be the last ass whooping our people got to get collectively, man. And that's when two-thirds are going to be wiped out. And that's also what's going to cause Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shah to return. Okay? That's what he's going to return and judge these nations in the Valley of Jehoshaphat, man. But let's continue though. Pharaoh, king. Now let's continue to who else is going to drink this wine of destruction. Okay. Pharaoh, king of Egypt, and his servants, and his princes, and all his people, and all the mingled people, and all the kings of the land of Uz, and all the kings of the land of the Philistines, and Ashkelon, and Azai, and Ekron, and the remnant of Ashdod, Edom, and Moab, and the children of Ammon, and all the kings of Tyrus, and all the kings of Zidon, and the kings of the Isles which are beyond the sea, Dedan, and Temah, and Buz, and all that are in the utmost corners, and all the kings of Arabia, and all the kings of the mingled people that dwell in the desert, and all the kings of Zimri, and all the kings of Elam, and all the kings of the Medes, and all the kings of the north, far and near, one with another, and all the kingdoms of the world which are upon the face of the earth, and the king of Shishak shall drink after them. Therefore, so the Lord just put the curse on the whole entire, on all the nations, man. That's a corner to corner, the world, everything upon the face of the earth. All nations are going to drink this cup. Okay. Therefore, thou shalt say unto them, thus saith the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, drink ye and be ye drunken and spew and fall and rise no more, because of the sword which I will send among you. Yeah, this pestilence, the bubonic plague is popping up in China now. The whole world just had a COVID epidemic, you know, the beginning of this year, that caused a shutdown and really hurt the economies. Now we COVID round two. Yeah, everything's shutting back down. Plus the bubonic plague on top of that. These murder hornets are mating. Yeah, how about should we have a shot? Got beautiful judgments for this earth, man. Especially, chiefly, and primarily America. That's the horror of the earth, man. Unfortunately. You know, it's just the truth, okay? I wish I could lie to you, give you good news like Pope Francis is, and lie to you people and tell you that everything is going to be beautiful and okay. Yeah, it is for the elect. And even the elect is going to be tried a little bit. You feel me? But majority of these people, you about to die, man. Majority of these people about to die, dog, period. Okay? Famine, pestilence, there's various swords of Yahabashim, Yahabashai. Wild beasts, strange apparitions and demons. Yeah, all this is about to be unleashed on the earth, man. And you certainly going to drink it. Okay? If you ain't right with Yahabashim, Yahabashai. Let's continue to 28. And it shall be, as they refuse to take the cup of thine hand to drink, then thou shalt say unto them, thus saith the Lord of hosts, ye shall certainly drink. For lo, I begin to bring evil on the city which is called by my name. That's Israel. That's the nation of Israel. He going to begin with Jacob's trouble and start tearing up, getting our people up out of here. And he even began with our people for the last 400 years to bring judgment on our people. Okay? And should ye be utterly unpunished? So the Lord's saying, so I punish my own house, my own inheritance, my own tabernacle, people I have a covenant with, but I'm not going to punish y'all? Yeah, it's all death and destruction coming for the world, man. You shall not be unpunished, for I will call a sword upon all the inhabitants of the earth, saith the Lord of hosts. Is the raw Hebrew saying it? Well, I'm saying it because, you know, this is the word of the Lord, but no, I didn't write this. Get mad at the Most High, man. Get mad at Yahabashim, Yahabashai. It's not going to fucking matter either. Because the judgments are still going to come, whether you like it or whether not. Now, if you want to believe there's going to be peace on the earth, go ahead and believe that. And then when you walk outside and you hear mortars going off, and you step outside in the middle of the night, you see paratroopers hitting your streets and Russian tanks going up and down your streets, and UN peacekeepers kicking in doors and dragging the... Man, it's about to get bad. I talk about it all the time. You know what I'm saying? Then you can't say you didn't know, because the men of the Lord are prophesying this to you people, man. Therefore prophesy thou against them all these words. There we go. And say unto them, the Lord shall roar from on high and utter his voice from his holy habitation. He shall mightily roar upon his habitation. He shall give a shout as they that tread the grapes against all the inhabitants of the earth. That sound like peace to y'all. Told you how about Shem Yahushua is against all these nations. I just told you on my last video, Jeremiah 25. And in case y'all didn't have time to read it for on your own, I'm reading it to you right now, man. A noise shall come even to the ends of the earth, for the Lord hath a controversy with the nations. He got beef with these nations, man. Okay? He will plead with all flesh. He will give them that are wicked to the sword. Hallelujah, man. Saith the Lord, Yahabashim, Yahabashai, man. Yeah. If you wicked, you about to be, man, it's about to be over. And it's funny because the wicked is even waxing wickeder, man. With these, I was just on World Star Hip Hop, man, the other day. And the video was like too graphic for me to post. But I came across a video where there was like a house party, I think in Arizona, man. And they had a bunch of strippers in there, man, and they was just doing all types of abominable acts, man. Just a giant orgy, man. And a lot of these people were Jakes. They were Israelites in there, man. Talking about women shoving cucumbers up themselves, man. Going down on each other. Just being lewd. See, these same people are about to get destroyed, man. Through famine. Some of these women are going to be eating their own children. You know what I'm saying? Through pestilence. The Lord going to take out more people with the second round of COVID, with the bubonic plague, with all these pestilence and destruction that's coming. He's going to call the troop to fall upon a lot of these whores, a lot of these sent men who was supporting it and not keeping these women in order and support this wickedness. They're going to be put to death. Their families are going to be spoiled right before their eyes. They're going to be tied up while they watch their children get decapitated alive, while your enemy laughs at you. Man, them Russians ain't about to play with you people, man. Yahabashim, Yahabashai is about to turn it up, turn these nations up against this place, man. Yeah, this is real talk, bro. This is about to happen. Jeremiah, the 15th chapter, verse 4 through 6. For all the unfaithful shall die in their unfaithfulness. Behold, saith the Lord, I'll bring plagues upon the world, the sword, famine, death, and destruction. For wickedness has exceedingly polluted the whole earth, and their hurtful works are fulfilled. Yeah, man. The hurtful works are fulfilled, man. Real talk. I think that sounds like that's in Ezra, man. I think I might have it wrong. Let's double check. Jeremiah 15, 4 through 6. Let's see. Make sure I ain't tripping, because I could have sworn that's in Ezra. I may be wrong. Yep. That's in 2nd Ezra chapter 15. Akim, I'm sorry. Let's fix that. See, the spirit quickened me, man. Salah. Spirit quickened me on that one. That's 2nd Ezra chapter 15, verse 4 through 6. Let's save that. Let's save that right now. Save that. Let's double check. I knew that wasn't right. For all the unfaithfulness shall die in their unfaithfulness. Behold, the Lord, I will bring plagues upon the world, the sword, famine, death, and destruction. For wickedness has exceedingly polluted the whole earth, and their hurtful works are fulfilled. See, yeah, so lucky about that, Akim. You know? And Microsoft Word is funny. Sometimes when I'm building these lessons, man, like, it be switching up certain stuff, misspelling stuff. It's weird, man. But yeah, that's my fault on that one. That was 2nd Ezra 15, 4 through 6. But nonetheless, death and destruction's coming for this place, man. Not no peace and prosperity and holding hands and kumbaya, man. Ain't none of that going on, man. Let's go to Jeremiah chapter 50, verse 9 through 16. For lo, I will raise and cause to come up against Babylon an assembly of great nations from the north country, and they shall set themselves in array against her. From thence she shall be taken. The arrows shall be as of mighty expert men. None shall return in vain. Yeah, Yahabashim Yahabashai is going to cause these nations to come up against the daughter of Babylon. You understand? And they're going to be letting off these nukes. That's what these arrows mean, these missiles. This is going to smack America. I did a video, I think it was called "And Bazar Shall Be a Burnt Offering" or something of that nature. And I recorded a video from a movie. I forgot the movie it was, but it was showing how all these nations had their submarines, their nuclear with nuclear heads on them, and was launching an attack against every U.S. major city, man. It was blown into smithereens, man. The Lord showed me this in vision when I was a child, man. I've seen the missiles. I've seen the death and destruction, yo. I've seen it. Like, it's not nothing. Like, I'm not just saying. I'm not, like, lying to y'all. I've seen the times we're about to come into that ain't happened yet. These cities are about to get bought down, man. A lot of people about to die, man. Real talk. A lot of people about to die, man. And Chaldea shall be a spoil. All that spoil her shall be satisfied, saith the Lord. Because ye were glad, because ye rejoiced, O ye destroyers of my heritage. Yeah. Because Esau, Edom destroyed Israel, man. Since we've been here, it's been just a perpetual destruction of Jacob. Granted, you know, it was the will of Yahabashim, Yahabashai, for our people going off, our forefathers going off, and even until this day, they're going off. So that's why he's going to be justified in killing 2/3 of young niggas in Jacob's trouble, okay? Because you're not Israelites, you niggas. You lawless. You brute beast. You understand? This is what got us into slavery in the first place. Yahabashim Yahabashah has opened the eyes of whom he shall open the eyes of, to where they can be spared. You understand? Find grace and repentance. You understand? But let's continue. It says, because ye are grown fat as the heifer at the grass, and below as bulls. Your mother shall be sore confounded. She that bare you shall be ashamed. Yeah, over there in the West, in Europe, the United Nations, and the Queen of England, and the United Kingdom, man, they're going to be ashamed when this place get effed up. They're going to be like, damn. You know, yeah, it's talking about the place that birthed this country. Okay? Behold, the hindermost of the nation shall be a wilderness, a dry land, and a desert. Because of the wrath of the Lord, it shall not be inhabited, but it shall wholly be desolate. Everyone that goeth by Babylon shall be astonished and hiss at all her plagues. Put yourselves in array against Babylon round about, all ye that bend the bow. Shoot at her, spare no arrows, for she hath sinned against the Lord. Yes, sir, that's the plague and the curse that's going to be on this land. You might be like, oh, this is talking about ancient Babylon. Man, there's nothing new under the sun. This is the new Babylon. It's perpetual. Yahabashim Yahabashah's judgment is perpetual, man. If you don't want to believe it, then be confounded in the day of judgment, man. You'll be running for your lives, bitching up, shitting on yourself, running down the street, man, with feces staining your denims, man. Yeah. You people are about to be terrified, man. Yeah. No bull. When you hear that sonic boom of those jets, shaking up your house, of them fighter jets, and they're gonna be dropping carpet bombs and missiles in your neighborhoods. Yeah, this ain't gonna be, man. The daughter of Babylon about to have her virgin cherry popped, man. The same way our country went to other nations and destroyed them, dropping nukes, dropping bombs, and subjugating other countries, man. Yahabashim Yahabashah is gonna ride with these other countries to do the same unto this place. Okay, shout against her round about. She hath given her hand. Her foundations are fallen. Her walls are thrown down. For it is the vengeance of the Lord. Take vengeance upon her as she hath done. Do unto her. Woo! Didn't I just say that? Cut off the sower from Babylon and him that handleth the sickle in the time of harvest. Yeah, famine's coming. For fear of the oppressing sword, they shall turn everyone to his own people, and they shall flee one to his own land. Everyone to his own land. Yeah, people gonna click up. The nations are going to click up, man. The whites are going to run with the whites. Jakes are going to deal with Jakes. You know, when I say Jakes, I mean so-called Negroes, Hispanics, and Native Americans, the sons of Jacob. The Chinese are going to deal with the Chinese, the Koreans with the Koreans. Everybody's going to be terrified. They're going to flee to their own people. Jeremiah chapter 50, verse 22 through 43. A sound of battle is in the land and of great destruction. How the hammer of the whole earth cut asunder and broken. How Babylon become a desolation among the nations. Yep, this is the hammer of the earth. This has been the one place that's been subjugating the earth, man, to run with their program, to deal with their monopoly money, their Federal Reserve notes. You know, but this petrol dollar is about to fail. Everything's about to fail, man. And the whole hammer of the earth, this place, America, is about to be cut asunder, man, and broken. And you don't see it? You don't see that America's over, man? I have laid a snare for thee, and thou art also taken, O Babylon, and thou was not aware. Yeah, because you people think everything can go back to normal, okay? Thou art found and also caught, because thou hast striven against the Lord. Yeah, America strives against the Lord. If you talk about anything righteous, yo, people will come up against you here. And the wickedness is a normality here, Babylon, America, okay? But Yahabashim Yahabashah got something for that. The Lord hath opened his armory and hath brought forth the weapons of his indignation. For this is the work of the Lord God of hosts in the land of the Chaldeans. Come against her from the utmost border. Open her storehouses. Cast her up as heaps and destroy her utterly. Let nothing of her be left. Slay all of her bullocks. Let them go down to the slaughter. Woe unto them, for their day is come, the time of their visitation. The voice of them that flee and escape out of the land of Babylon, to declare in Zion the vengeance of the Lord our God, the vengeance of his temple. Yeah, that's what we're doing. Yeah, yeah. The elected is declaring this to the nations, man. You know? Call together the archers against Babylon, all ye that bend the bow. Camp against it round about. Let none thereof escape. Recompass her according to her work, according to all that she hath done. Do unto her. She hath been proud against the Lord and the Holy One of Israel. Yeah, yeah, y'all have. Therefore shall her young men fall in the streets, and all her men of war shall be cut off in that day. Behold, saith the Lord. Behold, I am against thee, O thou most proud, saith the Lord God of hosts. For thy day is come, the time that I would visit thee. And the most proud shall stumble and fall, and none shall raise him up. And I will kindle a fire in his cities, and it shall devour all about him. Yep, that nuclear warfare, man, and these missiles. It ain't just going to be nukes. It's going to be all types of missiles smacking this bitch. Thus saith the Lord of hosts, the children of Israel and the children of Judah was oppressed together. Okay, we sure were. We just talked about that earlier. And all that took them captives held them fast, and they refused to let them go. Their Redeemer is strong. The Lord of hosts is his name. He shall thoroughly plead their cause. So Yahabashim, Yahabashai is going to plead your cause, man. When he calls all these nations to jump on these Edomites over here, man. That's really what's going to happen. You don't got to do too much right now. You don't got to do nothing but prophesy and study and try to you got to try to seek Yahabashim, Yahabashai's face that he may hear your prayer. That's all you got to do. Okay, that he may give rest to the land and disquiet the inhabitants of Babylon. He can make all y'all shut the hell up. A sword is upon the Chaldeans, saith the Lord, and upon the inhabitants of Babylon, Selachia, and upon her princes, and upon her wise men. A sword is upon the liars, and they shall dote. A sword is upon her mighty men, and they shall be dismayed. Ye, all your Navy SEALs, your National Guard, your Marine Corps, man, y'all about to get smashed, man. A sword is upon their horses, and upon their chariots, and upon all the mingled people that are in the midst of her. Yeah, all these mingled people. Because it ain't just like in ancient Babylon, you had all these different nations of people in this great city. Here in the United States of America, man, you have all these foreigners and everybody just comes together here. It's a mixing pot. It's a melting pot here, man. And they shall become as women. Yeah. Oh, man. Yahabashim, Yahabashai, when he bring these judgment, people going to bitch up, man. A sword is upon her treasures and they shall be robbed. A drought is upon her waters and they shall be dried up. For it is the land of graven images. And they are mad upon their idols. Therefore, the wild beasts of the desert and the wild beasts of the island shall dwell there, and the owls shall dwell therein. And it shall no more be called Selachia, and it shall no more be inhabited forever. Neither shall it be dwelt in from generation to generation. As God overthrew Sodom and Gomorrah and the neighbor cities thereof, saith the Lord, so shall no man abide there, neither shall any son of man dwell there. Yeah, America's gonna be desolate, man. It's like a desert out this bitch. Behold, a people shall come from the north, and a great nation, and many kings shall be raised up from the coast of the earth. They shall hold the bow and the lance. They are cruel and will not show mercy. Oh, man, the Russians ain't about to show y'all no mercy, man. The Russians are coming. They're going to invade this bitch. They already got incels here. Them Arabs, the Iranians, they not going to show you people no mercy, man. Oh, man, Esau's about to be a vagabond, man. He's about to be like... It's about to be really unpopular to be a white person, man. It's about to be a very, very, very unpopular thing, man. It's like being around them might get you killed in this day, man. Because all these nations are really against America, man. And they're about to show it. And Yahabashim, Yahabashai's behind it all. Their voice shall roar like the sea. They shall ride upon horses. Everyone put in the army. Everyone put in array. Like a man to the battle against the old. Uh-oh. Here it go. Verse 42. Look, y'all, for all the scoffers and mockers who think this is some past shit. Yeah, and it was. This is perpetual. There you go. What does it say? Oh, daughter of Babylon. Woo! There we go. You know that's America, man. Come on. These judgments are coming for this place, man. Come on. The Pope want to talk about peace. Man, no damn peace, man. There's warfare, bloodshed, and destruction coming in this place, man. Oh, daughter of Babylon. The king of Babylon hath heard the report of them, and his hands waxed feeble. Anguish took hold of him, and pains as of a woman in travail. Yep. These mayors, the presidents, the governors, all these politicians, they're going to be in their bunkers just like, man, they're going to be nauseous of fear when they see all this going on, man. Isaiah chapter 13, verse 19. In Babylon, the glory of kingdoms, the beauty of the Chaldees' excellency shall be as when God overthrew Sodom and Gomorrah, because it's going to rain fire from these missiles out here, man. This place going to get lit up, man. Yeah. A lot of people about to die, man. Psalm 137, verse 7 through 8. Remember, O Lord, the children of Edom in the day of Jerusalem, who said, raise it, even to the foundations thereof. O daughter of Babylon, I keep bringing this out because this is a precept. Y'all need to know. Psalms 137:7-8. This precept links the daughter of Babylon to Esau, Edom, y'all. Okay? It says, O daughter of Babylon, who art to be destroyed, happy shall he be that rewardeth thee as thou hast served us. Happy shall he be that taketh and dasheth thy little ones against the stones, man. That might be like, oh, that's harsh, you know. It's like, you can't speak judgment in this place, man. This place is so pussified and backwards, you know. But the scriptures say, happy shall he be who taketh and dasheth thy little ones against the stone, because Esau's going to be cut off. All the males are going to be... The nephew, man, Isaiah 14:21-22, man. Obadiah, a whole book dedicated to these people, man. It's all over the place in the scriptures, man. Edom is going to get cut off, man. It's just going to be the woman. And a lot of them going to get put to death. But all the men is going to be destroyed in the wars, man. Okay? People are like, oh, that's evil. I had somebody tell me, I got put in Facebook jail not too long ago because I was prophesying on Facebook. Somebody told me it was wicked to take joy and people suffering. You know what? Let's go to Ecclesiastes 25:7. There be 9 things which I have judged in my heart to be happy, and the 10th I will utter with my tongue. A man that has joy of his children, and he that liveth to see the fall of his enemy, man. Supposed to be happy. That's supposed to make your heart happy to see the fall of these people who enslaved your ancestors and still killing your children on these streets and all this injustice, man. Y'all about to have a shot of gas on for him, and it ain't the P word. What's the P word? Peace. It's none of that. Ain't none of that coming to this place, man. Let's go ahead and end it with Luke 10:23-24. And he turned him unto his disciples and said privately, okay, this is Jehovah Shah. Blessed are the eyes which see the things that you see. For I tell you that many prophets and kings have desired to see those things which you see and have not seen them, and to hear those things which you hear and have not heard them, man. So we're living in beautiful times, not peaceful times, but beautiful times. It's going to be beautiful for the elect, man. You know, I pray that I was edifying, man. Ain't no peace coming to this place, not to America, not to the world at large. It's over. And all praises to the Most High and our Adonai, Yahweh Shai, okay, our Savior, in which repentance is given. Israelites need to repent, come back to this truth, come back to this doctrine, seek understanding, okay? Come back to the laws, man, because it's going down. The clock is ticking. One day, and suddenly, it's going to go down, okay? Missiles are going to be smacking this bitch. You're going to see tanks on the street. You're going to see these blue helmets unleashed. These UN peacekeepers is about to get really real out here, okay? You're about to see terrorist attacks like never before. It's about to get really real out here, okay? And the plagues are going to consume this earth, man. This earth is through. This earth is languishing. This earth is over, man. It's going to be a new heaven and a new earth. And that's what we should be looking forward to and working towards every day, man. You know, but I